A somber mood engulfed Parliament as the body of Mathias Nsubuga, the former Bukoto-South Member of Parliament and seasoned politician, arrived. The Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, the Clerk to Parliament and members of the Parliamentary Commission were part of the team that received his funeral cortege. The casket was later taken to the parliamentary lobby for public viewing, where the speaker led mourners in paying their respects to the late. At 2 p.m., the body was ushered into the chambers, where members of parliament paid tribute to the former chairman of the Inter-Party Organization for Dialogue, IPOD, and Secretary General of the Opposition Democratic Party, one of the country's oldest political parties. MPs from different political shades joined together in mourning a man who has been described as a teacher and a library of Uganda's political history.
He believed in truth and justice. He believed in fairness. He believed in humanity. Nsubuga knew the value of friends.
Right from his youth, Honorable Mathias Nsubuga was a police activist who championed democracy and challenged the dictatorship.
The motion to pay tribute to Nsubuga was moved by Prime Minister Ruhakana Rugunda and seconded by the opposition chief whip Winnie Kiza.
This parliament takes cognizance of the dedicated service and contribution that the late Honorable Mathias Nsubuga has in the course of his illustrious life rendered that of Uganda.
Many MPs described him as a selfless politician who put the country first.
He was a peaceful man. He was a man of good character.
He would give guidance, national guidance, on matters of public importance, and that's why we mourn his demise. He has been a teacher, he has been a parent, an educator who wants a new generation to take over. Mathias has been a nationalist, a pan-Africanist. He's a good leader.
Meanwhile, Vice President Edward Sekandi described his moments with the late.
Saturday, he told me I'm coming. He said, oh, you're welcome. But I didn't see him on Saturday then. Maybe there was interruption. When I came back to Kampala, I was told he fell sick, he's in the hospital.
Mathias Nsubuga suffered a stroke on Friday.
Honorable Nsubuga had gone to the corner of the shop to buy a present for His Eminence Emmanuel Cardinal Wamala, who was celebrating his 90th birthday on Friday, 5th December 2016. A function which I and several other people attended. Sadly, he did not make it the function.
He joined active national politics in 1978. The former accountant with the defunct Uganda Airlines will be buried on Thursday in Luengo.